Yeah, and he's extremely happy to just play the game and play consistent high level there. Yeah, but yes, I didn't actually think Valmaster would play this fixture entirely, but boy, was I wrong. And again, he was one of the players that was extremely reliable last SFL.
It just goes to show the strength of a... So, extremely reliable last SFL.
Yeah.
Problem X, mostly reliable last SFL. Phenom, extremely reliable last SFL. Now, out of those three teams, 00 Nation, Mouse, BMS, we're now going into week two, and both Mr. Crimson and Problem X haven't even needed to feature.
Nor is Crimson.
So Mr. Crimson and Problem X haven't even, I mean, Phenom's always going to be there, right? But it just goes to show the strength for the teams this season is crazy to me. Problem X chilling, picks the team, and we have a guy like Mystic can come along and anchor. In this one, we can send up the talent of Valmaster, who's now on the squad with BMS, allowing a guy like Mr. Crimson to just take a break too. Incredible strength and depth for both of these teams.
Yeah, that deep depth squad that they all have is actually brilliant to see. Now, obviously, going on to the matchup here, Chun-Li versus Ken. I like that he's openly admitting certain things now, not downplaying Chun-Li like he did before. it is a 5-5 matchup. Not
a 5-5 matchup. It's not good. Look, judging from a Valmaster. So it's 5-5. It's 5-5.
Oh, no.
I love playing him so much. He is so good. He is so high level. We play the game and we have so much fun. Yeah, what about you, Valmaster?
No. He plays Ken. It's not fun for me, bro.
He's admitting it, mate. He's admitting it.
Just goes to show these Kens are playing a different game to us, bro. They're having fun. We're winning, but we're still stressed out.
Look, man, you want to be the one causing the problems, not dealing with them. Or dealing with them. Yeah. Right, there we go. He's up in the corner here. Swings it out. Nice.
Looking for that fireball.
Just the crouching medium punch in the Serenity stance.
That counter hit and converts. Back heavy connects. It's a nice round so far for Mr. Crimson, but we know the corner means very little against Ken. Ah, nice bait. I'm not sure that was even plus.
I mean, I like that he's taking the early gamble just to see what Valmaster is going to be doing after certain buttons and certain strings on offense there. Let him know. A good identification there from Valmaster to block the reversal. Oh, okay.
Straight away.
Extensio kicks. And I will say, wow, what a block. And the dash under. And this is looking fantastic.
Still gets a roundhouse after that dash as well.
Beautiful stuff here from Valmaster at the moment. He's about to go to his level 3 as well, Leftward.
Oh, man, you've got to love watching this guy play. He's looking for that confirm off that stand medium punch now. He's got level 3 to go if he gets it. It's guaranteed confirm status there, one bar.
Yeah, lovely.
Oh, there he
fantastic
is.
Check. And then...
He saves it, wasn't going to kill. Love that run escape. Great awareness. Oh, he did the back dash. He did. Oh, that's so unlucky.
Nice.
He actually did the back dash to bait the Stanford. Stanford didn't come in. Cool,
frère. T'inquiète. Respire, frère. Tranquille. T'as pas besoin de montrer des trucs de fou. Joue bien. T'as pas besoin de montrer des trucs de fou.
En fait, il a juste mis des points sur les loupés de ta part, tu vois, les dragons. Ouais, etc. C'est tout, hein. Tu sais, il t'a pas forcément ouvert le mec.
Comes out on, I'll take it. It's a big ass. It's a big ass, but I like the fact that he attempted it as opposed to not doing anything at all. So if it did work out, we've got the answer.
Two hard reads. Yeah. Hard read backdash, hard read head stomp.
I mean, he's
worked out for Valmaster.
He's gone for a lot of calls that haven't worked out in that first battle there, but we're going into battle two. To find out what happens here.
Great start from Valmaster here, trying to get his team to that 40-0 win.
Next rival.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, that.
Confirm.
Ooh.
Actually had the stand for him.
Yeah, if he was ready with the stand fist a little bit earlier, a couple of frames earlier, then he would have got huge mileage from that in the corner.
Nice check. Wasn't confident the rest of the target combo was going to reach. I thought it would.
All right, good parry.
Oh, this time the back dash does work.
Oh,
he's so good at reading the throws.
I think a lot of Chun-Li players are very good at understanding where the opponent wants to throw them, especially if you've got a throw loop in the corner. It becomes a little bit more obvious.
Yeah, this guy's way more consistent than the ones I watch, bro. He's had so many good calls.
Oh, there we go. He's in burnout here, and he held his ground in the last week when he was in burnout against Joker Jokes incredibly well, and I think he can do it again here. Yeah, just holding his ground. He's about to get his drive gauge back.
Check.
There it is, completely recovered.
Counter hit. Oh, that's unfortunate.
Press the button.
He pressed the button. Pressed the button at the wrong time. Great play from Kane there, able to close that one out. His first round of the set so far.
Sometimes you are going to press the button at the wrong time, and it will.
Oh, that's perfect.
The round. Oh, wake up, the forwards.
Medium, man, this guy's calls.
Hey, BMS have actually been pretty damn decent with them wake up, the forwards.
Seriously, man.
waiting again. Again, they're playing too close here. I think it's at that range. They're only going to throw fireballs at each other. Yeah, unless they're going to arbitrate a drive rush in. You don't really see that from Chun-Li. She coats it with a Kokoken, so. Anti-air there. Well, he got the anti-air, the stand medium kick. I thought he was looking for Tensho kicks, but that can be difficult to do on stick, so.
Just run stop there to cover ground and catches him by surprise with that crouch jab. The meaty throw connects. And again. Right, again. Oh, he actually texts for once.
Fireball,
nice check.
Check. Yeah, it's too close. Recover from the block stun a little bit earlier than
Kenneth. Yeah, you need to hit later, then you've got the plus frames. Trying to burn her out here. He missed it. Missed his drive rush and burnt himself out. Ooh, drain on it. Wow. And it's scramble. That seven frame crouch medium kick. So good in scramble situations like that. Kane bringing it over to one apiece here and making it a little bit messy, a little bit more chaotic. Not completely. He's playing slow. He's playing patient, but just getting Valmaster in less comfortable situations here, which I like. I think the extremely slow Ken play is going to work in Valmaster's favor.
It's the thing, similar to Takamura going up against Phenom earlier in this episode, we've seen a very similar scenario with Kane and Valmaster. Just get them to play out of their comfort zone, man. You'd be very surprised at the defensive decision they make, and you get punished hard for the incorrect defensive decision.
Right, that's a wake up. Was actually the right call.
Yeah.
But didn't get a punished target combo.
He's got back throw there, so he gets a positional
nice
advantage.
Cool.
About to be a side swap with a down foot heavy kick into the conversion here. No EX fireball after the throw tech there. He's not that impatient yet, Kane.
Oh, bad fireball. He's had a few of those. Didn't go for the corner carry with the Tatsu there.
I think he was all right. I think he's all right with this scenario. I didn't say punish counter, so he could have blocked in time.
Yeah, great point, Jammers.
Next away again. Their life deficit is not in Kane's favor at the moment.
Oh, what a check. Elbow to the chest. Where are you going? He's going to spend the cash here to kill.
Number one should do it.
Very optimal. We spoke about that earlier, Jammers. You called it. That is a great example of optimization. Not overspending, not underspending, and still getting the kill.
That's it. He's still got one super gauge to work with here. It's Kane. Perfect parry.
Check.
Forward medium punch check, I should say. Sorry. Let's say stand medium punch. Oh, he tried to perfect parry a light. See, very few players in the European region at high level doing that. Ending Walker's one of them, so I respect the attempt to get
Ending
it.
Ending Walker's like a staple, but yeah, you're right, for the most part.
Ken, these guys are just slowing it down. Like you said, this works.
Oh, what an anti, yeah, that's such good damage as well.
Dude, that's like 20%, 25%.
So good.
And this style, this pace is working extremely into Valmaster's favor.
Hits again, should be able to kill here, level two.
Not messing around.
Great control from Valmaster, man. Just when Kane looked like he could start creating a bit of chaos, getting him a bit flustered, he was able to slow it down. He checked about three drive rushes in a row. I didn't see any drive rush on block actually working in that third battle. That's crazy.
What was that? Was that a 40-second perfect?
It was a perfect? I wasn't
was
even looking.
Perfect.
God,
yeah,
damn,
perfect.
That's
that was probably, well, that's the longest perfect we've had thus far.
Yeah, slow perfects, man. Only the best of the best pull those ones off.
It's crazy how you can have actually long perfects in this Street Fighter iteration. I didn't think that would actually be possible in a Street Fighter game.
Well, the no chip definitely helps with that.
Yes, that is entirely true. All right, let's see if Kane tries to speed things up to equalize. Goes back and forth.
Ooh.
Nice.
Love that.
Loops into the empty jump
throw. Love it.
For again, he's not going to do wake up Tensho kicks, so yeah, he's going to take all of this. Yeah, he's going to take all of this.
Oh my goodness, please, Val must have stopped.
He made the decision, and it worked out.
Still, the damage has been done. Huge life lead.
Next viable. Missed it. Too far to get the whiff on his down the stand heavy kick. I don't know what the hurt box is like on the lower part of Chun-Li's body, so. Just backs away here. Yeah, they'll wait, man. These guys, they will go and read a book and come back.
Heck, Valmaster refuses to die here. And Kane's almost burnt out. He is burnt out.
Well, oh, he can
overhead. It's towards the corner. This is bad. Oh, nice tech. Could have juggled there.
Oh, that's blast. Oh. Heavy lightning.
Oh,
left.
Here it comes. He's going to drive it back. He's got level two. He's buffering. Oh,
wow.
Green run overhead. From Kane.
What a commitment there, F word. Because look, he could have done run, stop, cancel. Like the run cancel. Sorry, yeah.
I'm surprised Valmaster walked that far back and didn't put a fireball on the screen, though.
Well, I mean, the fact that Kane had that bravado should tell you enough of how he's feeling about just this whole time being here, this whole experience of SFL.
I mean, he's loving it. If you look at his reaction, even on the chair, he's super pumped for this.
Of course.
And he's also having fun, which makes him dangerous.
The last thing you want is that an opponent having fun. I want to try and sack that out of him. X away again, Valmaster here. Slowing it down.
Another brilliant round from Valmaster so far.
Yeah, but that turned around last round.
It did. Well, it's Ken, baby. You're never truly safe.
Listen. And another
Ken. He checks it.
He's been really consistent with those. And another perfect.
Wow, another amazing, optimized, perfect finish. Both meter and health. Utilized to absolute perfection there for Valmaster. He goes into game point here. He can get BMS a 40-0 win here in week two.
Yeah, it's just those timings on the forward medium punch. That's when a lot of mileage has been coming from with the drive rush cancels from the forward medium punch. But then, what's Kane's answer going to be? I think he really has to go aggro now. F word, but I don't think he wants to be too obvious.
He's tried. His drive rush is getting checked consistently.
Yeah, but he doesn't want to
Dragon
jump.
Lash is getting interrupted or drive impacted, and the drive rush is getting checked. I think you're right though, Jammers. He can't just sit still. He's got to mix it up.
Listen, man, throw everything in the kitchen sink if you have to. Oh, the hooker by Crook drives you a double dash there, steals some frames. Just backing away here at the moment here. Yeah, let that Kikoka dissipate completely and walk the throw from Valmaster.
There it is again.
With Roundhouse.
Yeah. Huge damage on this anti-air. What an anti-air. Look how much chunks he's going to lose for this.
You know, that's what I love about Street Fighter 6 is anti-air conversions into about 50% there. Now, what is Kane's response? He hasn't got CA available just yet.
Big jump. Huge jump.
He's going to keep, yeah, he's going to extend the combos, but he's not going to be burnt out, Valmaster. This is going to reduce the recovery time on his burnout gauge, Kane. But Valmaster has got a slither of dry gauge to work with here.
Are we
going to
see an EX reversal from Valmaster?
It could be.
No, he gets burnt out.
Ooh, the jump!
Oh, that was a bad jump. Going to get meter back, though. Any second now.
Oh, no, that's plus. That's plus as well.
Yeah! Let's go! Let's go! Encore!
La puissance!
Vas-y, mon gars! Let's go!
These guys are rambunctious in a good way. Let's not forget as well, I've been impressed by that other character he's been playing. No, Dalsim.
Oh yeah, he has got Dalsim.
Remember, BMS is actually the only team that possesses Dalsim.
I remember Kane said he doesn't really know, maybe he plays another Dalsim, but he doesn't play Mr. Crimson. So if he knows the matchup is through a different level of play.
I don't know, maybe I'm overthinking it. Yeah.
Tanner's looked emphatic, to be honest.
Yeah. Clinical performance is getting the results need be. Last game of the day. Chase him down, goes to the back for instead. Classic legacy, as they say. Takes him all the way to the corner.
That range on that crouch medium kick, man, gets us all.
Hey, it's one of the better ones in the game. You're looking at 2 7 frame crouch medium kicks here, but I think Chun-Li's
pretty sure Chun-Li has more range.
Yeah, I think it's Chun-Li's.
Nice EX. Didn't go for the knockdown there.
All right, there you go. Just trying to check something. Yeah, I think Kane's waiting for his drive gauge to come back just a little bit. Maybe over 2 bars if he gets it. Valmaster is not going to move an inch. Not going to... Ah, nice anti-air again.
Right, not going to happen.
Yeah, he's ready for that. He's ready for that.
Big bait.
Punish counter.
Burns him out as well.
Takes him straight to the corner there with the heavy tensho kicks. And then he's not going to try and... Not in this scenario anyway. Just going to wait, play patient.
A beautiful check. This time it was a preemptive one, but still the readiness to convert light to light.
It's interesting, once Kane gets sent full screen, or they're at the mid-range outside of Chun-Li's Stand Fierce range, I actually don't think I've seen Valmaster use Stand Fierce. He just feels stumped at how to approach, and for good reason. For good reason.
He's managed to find a way to at least Kane's Ken, to kind of control Ken, even though it's 2 apiece here. So you could argue he's not fully controlling Ken, but it's been uphill for Kane.
Well, listen, he's found
two least. Very slow perfects in there.
Listen, he's found the least for that rabid dog, I've got to say.
Oh, trying to do something on Wake Up. Saves the meter, takes the throw, brave tech, pays off.
I like it. These guys
Kane
are
back away now.
Yeah, runs in. Okay, commits to the low follow-up there. Just again, just slowing it down, even a run cancel again.
Oh.
Looking out here. Now, I think if he gets a huge
hit.
Oh,
that's huge.
Is he going to spin the level 3? No.
Keep it. One more hit will do it, though. Kane with it all to do.
I mean, it's definitely a tall order. It's not insurmountable, but...
Oh, what was that?
I'm not sure.
Got to be a fireball. Oh, he gets caught. That's it.
Nice. Yeah, man, we
win. Oh, yes. Yes. get themselves a 40-0 victory over their local rivals here, fellow Giants in the league this season. That is a massive result, Janus.